आज के लेक्चर में हम लोग देखेंगे कि हाउ ए स्क्वायर वेव कैन बी एनालाइज्ड एंड सिंथेसाइज्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ फूरियर सीरीज. सो व्हाट इज स्क्वायर वेव? ए वेव डिफाइंड बाय x इज इक्वल टू c फ्रॉम 0 फ्रॉम t इज इक्वल टू 0 टू t इज इक्वल टू t बाय 2 इन द पीरियड t इज इक्वल टू 0 टू t इज इक्वल टू t बाय 2 and x is equal to 0 from t is equal to t by 2 to t is equal to capital T is called a square wave. Why it is called a square wave? We have to look its graphical representation. Let there is two axes, that is y axis and x axis. In the x axis we have taken the time or period, and in the y axis we have taken the displacement. So as we know that its maximum value is c, so x maximum value is c. So at t is equal to 0 to t by 2, so dividing the period in equal interval, that is 0 to t by 2, next t by 2, that is t by 2 plus t by 2 is equal to capital T, next t plus t by 2 is equal to 3 t by 2. So 0 to t by 2, 0 to t by 2, its value is c, so its value is c. Next, from t by 2 to capital T, from t by 2 to capital T, its value is 0, so it is 0. Next, again, for next period, that is from t to t, t to 3 t by 2, or we can say that 0 to, this value is 0 here, so 0 to t by 2, its value is again c. So as we see that the figure resembles with or look like a square, look like a square. Therefore, this function is called a square wave. Now we have to find out the Fourier series for this and how Fourier series help us to find out the result of the square wave. So first we have to calculate the value of Fourier coefficients, that is a naught, AR and BR. So for that, analysis using Fourier theorem. We know that A naught is equal to 1 by t 0 to t x dt, but the value of the function is divided into two intervals, 0 to t by 2 and t by 2 to t. And from the property of definite integral, if a function can be divided into two intervals, if we have B and C. So if the function is from, we have to go from definite integral from A to C, then fx dx can be written as A to B and then B to C. In the similar way, we can write it as 1 by T 0 to capital T by 2 x dt plus T by 2 to capital T x dt. Now we have to put the value of x in both intervals. So 0 to capital T by 2, 0 to capital T by 2, its value is c, and T by 2 to capital T, T to capital T by 2, its value is 0. So in the next step, A naught is equal to 1 by T 0 to t by 2 c dt, and t by 2 to t, simply it is 0. So we have 1 by t, c is constant, so it comes out 0 to t by 2 dt. Integration of dt is equal to t, so 1 by t c t 0 to t by 2. So we have 1 by t into c t by 2 minus 0, upper limit minus lower limit. So 1 by t into c t by 2, t cancel out, so its value is c by 2. So the value of a naught is simply c by 2. Similarly, we will find the value of ar and br. To find the value of ar, Fourier coefficient, we know that ar is equal to 2 by t, 0 to t x sin r omega t dt. Next, we have to divide it into two intervals, that is 0 to t by 2 x sin r omega t dt plus second 2 by t 0 to capital T by 2, sorry, T by 2 to capital T x sin r omega t dt. We know that from the definition of square wave, the value of function x in the interval T by 2 to capital T is 0. So this is 0 for next term, that is 2 by t, 0 to t by 2. The value of function in the interval 0 to capital T by 2 is c sin r omega t dt plus 2 by t, 0 to capital T, t by 2 to capital T, 0 into sin r omega t. So 2 by t, c comes out, 0 to capital T by 2, sin r omega t, simply this value is 0. So next, 2c by t, integration of sin r omega t is equal to minus cos r omega t divided by r omega in the interval 0 to t by 2. So 2c divided by t minus, we take the minus outside and r omega also outside. So putting the value of upper limit, that is cos r, value of omega is equal to 2 pi by t. Cyclic frequency is equal to 2 pi by time period. So r omega is equal to 2 pi by t into capital T by 2 upper limit minus cos 0. Now minus 2c by t r, here the value of omega is 2 pi by t. 2 to cancel out, t cancel out, cos pi r minus cos 0 is equal to 1. T cancel. So we have minus c divided by pi r cos pi r minus 1, or we can write it as c divided by pi r 1 minus cos pi r. So the value of ar is equal to c by pi r 1 minus cos pi r. Now depending upon the value of r, there are two value of ar. R can be small, r can be even number, small r can be odd number. So when r is equal to odd means 1, 3, 5, if we take 1, that is cos pi means cos 180 degree. Converse 180 degree can be written as cos 90 plus 90, which is minus of sin 90 degree, that is minus 1. So its value is ar is equal to c divided by pi r 1 minus 1, that is 0. So when r is odd, the value of ar is equal to 0. Next, when R is equal to even. Even means the value of R would be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. For in this case, the value of cos 2 pi, general value 2 pi, will be cos 360 degree. Cos 360 degree is equal to cos 360 plus theta, plus 0 degree. So this is cos 0 degree. That means cos sine 90 degree. Okay, na? Sine 90 degree is equal to minus 1. So here, sorry, sine 90 degree is 1. That means this is 2c by 5. So when r is equal to odd, ar, the value of ar is 2c by pi r. And when r is equal to even, because their value is 1 minus cos pi r, and minus minus plus 2c by pi r. So when r is even, cos 2 pi, cos 360 degree, cos 360 degree can be written as cos 360 plus 0 degree, that is cos 0 degree, which is equal to 1. So in this case, ar is equal to c by pi r. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. So when r is equal to odd, in the square way, r is equal to odd, the value of a real coefficient ar is equal to 2c by pi r, and when r is equal to even, ar is equal to 0. That means we have to take the odd numbers of values of small r, not even number, because the even numbers will give the value of AR is equal to 0. Next, we will calculate the value of BR, which is equal to 2 by T 0 to T X cos R omega T dt. Again, this integration can be written as 0 to T by 2 x cos r omega t dt plus t by 2 to capital T x cos r omega t dt. Simply, the value of this function is 0 because square wave function for interval t by 2 to t is 0. So we simply write it as 0 to T by 2 C cos R omega T dt. So next, 2 by T C comes out, 0 to pi by 2, 0 to T by 2 cos R omega T dt. Again, 2 C by T, integration of cos omega T is sine R omega T divided by R omega 0 to T by 2. So it is 2C by T, R omega comes out, sine R omega, that means 2 pi by T, upper limit is T by 2 minus sine 0. T cancel, 2 cancel, and here 2c t r omega means 2 pi by t, t cancel. So we have sine pi r minus sine 0. Sine pi r means sine r pi, or sine pi means sine 180 degree, that is sine 90 plus 90, that is minus of cos 90, is equal to cos 90 degree is equal to 0, and sine 90 degree, sine 0 degree is 0. 0 minus 0, that means this value is 0. So for square wave, the coefficient BR is equal to 0. BR is equal to 0. So now, putting all the values, that is A naught, AR and BR, in the Fourier series, we can get the square wave equation. So after writing the all the values, as we know that x Fourier series is equal to x is equal to a naught summation r is equal to 1 to infinity ar sine r omega t plus summation r is equal to infinity 1 to infinity vr sin cos r omega t. As we have calculated, the value of a naught is equal to c by 2, and for r is equal to odd, a the value of ar is equal to 2c by pi r, and the value of br is equal to 0. So this term is 0, and this second term can be written from r is equal to 1, 3, 5 for odd numbers. So a naught is equal to c by 2. Next, for r is equal to 1, the value of ar will be 2c divided by pi, to 2c divided by pi sine omega t r is equal to 1. The next value will be, odd number will be 3, so this will be 2c divided by 3 pi, 2c divided by 3 pi sine 3 omega t. Similarly, next higher value of odd number is 5, to 2c divided by 5 pi sine 5 omega t. Similar terms goes, and we take 2c by pi common in all the terms, so we have sine omega t plus half 1 by 3 sine 3 omega t plus 1 by 5 sine 5 omega t. This gives the Fourier series of square wave. So when we draw the graph, first term will give the sine wave for one term, for three terms, calculation of three terms, then five terms, then seven terms. For odd number of terms, the square wave can be calculated. So next we will draw the graphical representation of this wave function. So when we draw the graph, in the figure 1, we see that if dotted line is this, this is the analysis of one term, then three terms, that is this comes three terms, three sine waves, 1 2 3, 1 2 3. So this continues to, if 15 terms, then this will give the result of adding of 15 terms, which is nearly equal to square wave. So this is the best treatment of Fourier, which give, we have taken the just the value of the function, that is the value of x is equal to c to from 0 to t by 2, and its value is 0 from the interval t by 2 to capital T, and we have calculated the Fourier coefficient a naught, ar and br, and put it in the Fourier series of Fourier theorem. And when we draw the graph having the terms, sinus term, sine terms, we will see that this graph looks like a square wave. So it is the synthesis of the wave. Now in the next video and the lecture, we will similarly synthesis and analyze the sawtooth wave with same idea and the same procedure.